What's up, everybody? Bike Builder Bear in the house. I'm gonna show you how to wash your bike without hurting your bike and getting the best result without spending a whole lot of money. Just keeping it simple. So, as you can see, it's an overcast day. I have over 15 years of automotive detailing experience, professional automotive detailing, and I can say that a big thing is try to find some shade under a tree or go to a car wash, one of those, you know, paid self-washing, you know, you wash it car wash, hand wash car wash things, or an overcast day like this. Even if it's gonna sprinkle a little bit, you could wash it, take it in your garage, and then chamois it down and blow it off and finish it off like that. But don't be afraid of a little bit of overcast, and you actually want some shade. You want shade. You don't want direct sunlight. Direct sunlight and soap and degreaser doesn't work good. Another thing, I recommend using Simple Green. I don't recommend using any detergent degreasers. If you use detergent degreaser, you're going to rot out your rubber, your grips. All of your plastics will start fading, graying out. Even your painted and powder coated products or parts and stuff will start fading and looking oxidized and horrible. So I always recommend use Simple Green or something natural like that, something that's a non heavy detergent. You know, there's degreasers out there that do the job. My go-to is Simple Green, you know. And don't ever put a heavy degreaser on stuff that's black or colored in the sunlight. You'll ruin it. You will see immediate spots. As soon as the degreaser dries, it's done. And then you're gonna have to come up with some kind of solution to refinish, you know, the finish on it, whether it be plastic, paint, or what it is. But I've seen stickers, I've seen sunlight and detergent degreaser do horrible things to cars. You know, 15 years of detailing, you're gonna learn a couple of things. You're gonna make mistakes. Nobody's perfect. So, you know, that being said, let me show you the simplistics of what you need to wash your bike and have it come out fabulous. First off, you're gonna need a bucket. You're gonna need a pressure washer. You don't have to break the bank. An electric pressure washer from Amazon will always do the trick. And some soap and water. That's all you need. You know, I prefer a simulated sheep cloth washing mitt. You know, and you can use microfiber cloths for your soap rag and stuff like that. And my preference is to just tie up a bag around the air filter, whatever kind of air filter you got, squirt it down, and go. And you know, I don't ever hit the top aesthetics or the handlebars with any kind of degreaser or anything like that. Usually that stuff just needs a light blow, just a light tap of soap on that stuff all up here. You just, you know, pat it and pressure wash. And my recommendation is always use a pressure wash. Don't ever just use the hose with a regular head. If you have one of those special heads that compress the water and give it more of a pressurized mist similar to a pressure washer, be careful. I recommend always using pressurized water, because what it does is it allows what they call a blow by. Like, yes, it's getting wet, but it's blowing by. It's not sitting there. The water's not being forced in through you know, tons of penetration of water. You just get a mist of it, and then it's not consistent solid water source. It's literally water vapor, you know, droplets of water getting blown over. And then I always recommend whenever you're done, I mean, even after you're done chamming, get a blower, blow the whole thing off, pull the seat off, blow it off, and then, you know, chamois it again, and you'll have the best result. As you can see, my case is all dirty, my rims are all dirty, my brakes are dirty, my forks are dirty, everything is dirty. Another thing you never want to do never, is you never want to stick this tip heavy into the clusters where the electrical is. Never heavy in there where the carburetor is. If it's that dirty, pull that stuff apart and clean it with brake cleaner and degreaser with hand rags. Another thing, don't ever pressure wash heavy next to your axle bolts. Don't ever do that. All you're going to do is you're going to push water into your bearings, okay? And then you're going to ruin your bearings when you're driving, because the oil and the water will solidify. The oil will, the grease will gum up. And if you don't got marine grease in those bearings, which I guarantee you most of you don't, even most of you haven't pulled apart your bearings and re-greased them with good grease, so you have the stock silicone grease, which will just evaporate and deteriorate with the water, and then you'll be running dry bearings, and then you'll blow out your bearings. So again, don't ever, yeah, and don't stick it up where the electronics are up here. Don't ever do that. Stay, the brakes, you know, in the brake caliper, you want to blast in there a little bit, that's fine. You know what I mean? But stay away from the axles, stay away from the carburation zone, and stay away from the electronics. Electronics and carburation and bearings and water can have a very, very sordid relationship. If you don't do it right, they don't work out. Okay, so my sheepskin was in a precarious place and needs to be ran through the washer, so I'm going to do it with terry cloth. You can get away with that if you're light-handed. But another trick, as always, start from the top, get all that stuff, and then get down there and get crazy, or else you're going to drag dirt from the bottom up. Another thing, chamois is key. Chamois is key. And always keep, and even when they're beat up, chamois are beat up. When they're beat up from the car, then they go to the interior of the car. And then when they have holes like this, then they could be used for your bike. But yeah, chamois are key. Key to the glamour. Water Sprite, chamois. I prefer the Water Sprite. And if you're in the mood to be doing something like this, before you tackle this job, you might want to do some, you know, maintenance. Check some of the bolts, you know, make sure that your axles, your motor mounts, stuff like that, that you get greasy, you know what I mean? Try to do some of that real quick before you wash it, and then wash it, and then afterwards you can go over the aesthetic stuff. It's a good idea. You already got your hands on the bike. You're already invested in time in it. Grab some Allen wrenches. Grab some wrenches. You know, and make sure everything's snugged up. Make sure everything's tight. So that not only do you have a pretty bike, but you have a bike that you feel confident going down the road that, you know, that things aren't going to fall apart on you. You know, and even any bike is like that, you know. You know, Harley Davidson's all the way to, you know, Yamaha Suzuki. It's a rider's, you know, job to make sure that his horse is healthy. So, you know, while you're doing this, it's probably a good idea to go ahead and, you know, check some nuts and bolts, make sure everything's tight. If things are loose, you know, throw some more Loctite on it, you know, and wash it up, you know. Clean it up. So I hope this video helps some of you out there that don't know how to get around, you know, cleaning this thing without the fear of doing damage to your bike, shorting out electrical, you know, doing damage, you know, to the carburation, you know, all kinds of weird stuff could happen. So please like, please subscribe. God bless and have a wonderful day.
I'm confused, I don't understand how you Christian but deny God in front of man. Oh, I get it, you don't want to lose your fans. Repent now for the kingdom.